Mr. True. Okay, we are going to do three examples of using De Moivre's theorem for finding complex roots that are in polar form. So we've got z sub k equals the nth root of r times the cosine of theta plus 2 pi k over n plus I sine theta plus 2 pi k over n, where k is a counting value starting at 0 and going up to n minus 1. Now I have this formula written in radians where it's 2 pi instead of 360k, but you can alternate back and forth, it's fine, and I think I'm going to do examples in both radians and degrees. So let's get started with our first example. So our first example I want to take a look at is I want all the complex roots of 27, and this is going to be, 27, z equals 27 cosine of 210 plus I sine of 210. Okay, so it's a pretty straightforward formula. The only problem is that it's a little bit long because you have more than just one root. If we're going to find a, I didn't say which root I wanted. Cube root. So, if we want all the cube roots, this says that we're going to go 0, 1, 2, da-da-da-da-da, all the way up to n minus 1. So k starts at 0, and if we're going to find all the cube roots, that means n is equal to 3. So we're going to use k values of 0, 1, and 2. Okay, so let's get this started. So we got the third root of 27 times the cosine, now this is in degrees, not radians, let me put the degree marks in there. So it's going to be the cosine of theta, which is 210, plus 360. I know I wrote 2 pi, but I'm going to do examples in both degrees and in radians. Right now I'm doing degrees, which is 360 for a full rotation, times k. Now k starts at 0. So 360 times 0 divided by n, the root that you're taking, cube root, okay, so n equals 3, plus I sine of the same thing, so theta, plus 360 times the initial value of k, which is 0, over n, we're taking the third root. I'm probably going to have to erase as I go, because I'm not going to fit all three up here at once. Or maybe just change it as I go. The cube root of 27 is 3. And we have the cosine. Now we have 360 times 0, of course, which is 0. So 210 divided by 3 is 70. Plus I sine of 210 plus 0 divided by 3. And 210 divided by 3 is 70 again. And that is the first cube root of 27 times cosine of 210 plus I sine of 210. But the trouble is, see, at least as far as my space is concerned, is there's two more. Let me try and squeeze one more down here. The next one is going to be the cube root of 27 times the cosine of 210 plus 360. But now we're going to let k step up one to one. So 360 times 1 divided by n, which is 3, plus I sine of 210 plus 360 times 1, again, over 3. And we're going to get, again, 3 times the cosine, 210 and 360. So we have 360, 560, 570 divided by 3. And 570 divided by 3 is 190. There we go. Okay, so we have the first root, which is 70. We have another root, which is 3 times the cosine of 190 plus I sine of 190. And now we're going to find the third root. Well, for the third root, I'm just going to write this again. And I'm going to write it for x for, for just, you know, the purpose of teaching, but you'll notice a pattern, especially if you have to do 3 or 4 or 5, 6 roots. You'll notice a pattern how these angles are growing, and you might want to shortcut it. Just make sure that you include all of the roots. If you're taking the 5th root, you'll have 5 roots. So we're going to have, as the last one, the cube root of 27 times the cosine of, again, 210 plus 360, only now it's going to be multiplied by 2, we're letting k go up to 2, over 3, the 3rd root, again, plus I sine of 210 plus 360, now multiplied by 2, divided by 3, and that's going to be 3 times the cosine. Again, just for practice, this is 720, 920, 930, and 930 divided by 3 is 310. Yep, just making sure. Plus I sine of 310 again. Good. Now, I said you would notice a pattern how these angles, you know, grow. This is 70, now you go to 190. Well, 70 and 190, that's a difference of 120. If I add 120 again to the 190, 190 and 120 makes up the 310. Now, I'm showing all the work because you're just learning, I'm assuming, how to find roots of complex numbers in polar form using the Moivre's theorem. So I'm just showing you all the steps. But if you start noticing that pattern, the difference between the angles, you can shortcut it a little bit. Okay, let's do another example. Okay, in this example, I'd like to find all the cube roots of just 27. Now we're using the Dubois theorem to find the roots, all the roots, of complex numbers in polar form. And here I'm just giving you 27. The cube root of 27 is 3. But that's only one of them. What about the others, the imaginary roots? And, you know, that's not even a complex number. Really, I don't have it written as a complex number. So let's write 27 as a complex number, where there's a real and imaginary part. So this is equal to 27 plus 0i. Now it's a complex number. And let's get that complex number into polar form. Well, that should always include a picture. So we have a point that's 27 units to the right on the real axis. That means that the the answer is z equals 27, because we're 27 units away from the origin, times the cosine of 0, I'm writing theta, plus I sine 0. And now we're going to find all the cube roots of that number, that complex number in polar form. So that's going to be the cube root of 27 again, times the cosine of, I'm going to do radians this time instead of degrees, my notes are in radians. Let's do the cosine of 0 plus 2 pi times 0 over 3, because we're finding third roots, plus I sine of 0 plus 2 pi times 0 over 3. Cube root of 27 again is 3. We have 0 divided by 3. So again, cosine of 0 plus I sine of 0. And so obviously that's kind of like the real cube root of 27, because we still have angle measures of 0. So we're looking at the 27, and the cube root of 27 is 3. So we're still on the real axis. Let's find the other two. And just to be lazy, I'm going to let k become now 1. So we're going to find now z sub 1. Those of you watching the video, you just realized what I did, right? We found the first real cube root, and now instead of letting k be 0, I'm letting k be 1. I'm too lazy to write all over again. So now the second root of this complex number in polar form would be the, and it will be the complex root, is we have 2 pi times 1, so it's going to be the cosine of 2 pi over 3, because it's 0 plus 2 pi times 1 over 3, so 2 pi over 3, plus I sine of 2 pi over 3. And 2 pi over 3, pi over 3 is 60 degrees, right? So 2 pi over 3 is over here. So we're kind of like, you know, I'm not going to do this exactly, but here's my guesstimation of where 3 is, and then now there's going to be another complex root over here in quadrant 2 of the imaginary coordinate system. And now we found z sub 0, we found z sub 1, and now we're going to find z sub 2. And we're finding, again, 3 complex roots because we're doing the cube root. If we're doing the fourth root, we'd find 4 answers. So now let's let k equal 2. And, you know, humor me on my laziness here, not wanting to write all that over again. Well, so cube root of 27 is still 3. 0 plus 2 pi times 2. 2 times 2 is 4, so 4 pi over 3. And again, 4 pi over 3. So there's another complex root down here somewhere where 4 pi over 3 is. One movement of 60 degrees, another rotation of 60 degrees, another rotation of 60 degrees, and then finally, so 1, 2, 3, 4 pi over 3. There's the 3 complex roots of 27. Didn't know the rest of many, did you? Okay, let's do one last example and call it a day with this video and just call it a day for me, period. Okay, we want to find the complex third roots of 1 minus I. Well, again, I'm giving you an example that's not already in polar form, so we need to get this complex number into polar form and then write the third roots of it. So, draw it out. Real, imaginary, right and down. And again, let's be honest, I'm using examples that I can quickly do in my head. I can figure out the angle by knowing using my knowledge of the unit circle. But yet, maybe a bit more complex for the type of questions in your book. I hope so anyway. So R is going to be the square root of 1 squared plus negative 1 squared. So we know, of course, that's square root of 2. And we're going to set up the tangent of theta. Just for practice, we know that it's 315 degrees or 7 pi over 4. But that's going to be negative 1 over 1. Again, if you're using or given a point that you can't just look at and tell what the angle is and you're using your calculator, theta equals the inverse tangent of negative 1 is going to give you negative 45 degrees. Well, negative 45 degrees is in quadrant 4 like the point is, but I want a rotation, I want an angle measure that's between 0 and 2 pi. So I want to manipulate the number out of the calculator a little bit and, you know, make sure that I have or I'm using an angle that's appropriate for how my question in my textbook is asking or wants the format of the question in. So let's see. Yeah, my notes are in degrees as well. So let's say theta is equal to 315 degrees. So we have a complex number that is square root of 2 in polar form. That's square root of 2 times the cosine of 315 degrees plus I sine of 315 degrees. And we're doing it in the third root because I don't want to do 5 or 6 different roots, you know, for the video. But we'll find third root again. And that is going to be z is equal to z sub 1, or sub 0, excuse me, is equal to the third root of 2, square root of 2. Actually, let's write that appropriately. And almost boggle this up a little bit. The third root, I can't just stick a 2 in the index. It's already a square root, right? So the square root of 2 raised to the 1/3 power, the square root of 2, now taking another third root of it, is going to be equal to, let's just figure that out so I can keep it through the rest of the question. The square root of 2 is 2 to the 1/2 power. And then that is raised to the third power because we're finding the cube roots. So 1/2 and a third makes 1/6, or the sixth root of 2. So when I was making my scratch work, I missed that. So hopefully, or thankfully, I didn't for the video. So the third root of the square root of 2 is the sixth root of 2, and that is y, okay? So let's go ahead and just write that answer so I can get it in down here. So the sixth root of square root of 2, and that is times the cosine of 315 plus 360 times 0, divided by 3 because we're doing cube roots, plus I times the sine of, again, 315 plus 360 times 0 over 3 because we're doing third root. And that comes out to be the sixth root of 2 times the cosine. 360 times 0 is 0, so 315 divided by 3 is 105 plus I sine of 105. And that's our first third root. Now for space, let's just come in here and change the 0 to a 1. And now we're going to find z sub 1 instead of z sub 0. I forgot to fill that in. And of course, all that's going to do is change the size of the angle. So 360, 660, 670, 675. So 675 divided by 3 is 325. No, it's not. 65 by 3 is 2, right? Okay. A little brain fade there. Okay, so thank you. So 675 divided by 2 is 2, or yeah, divided by 3, I mean, this is all messed up, is 225. Okay, so that's the first and the second root. Let's find the third root, and since I'm getting a little airheaded here, that'll be good that the video is almost over. Let's find z sub 2. And we have 720, 1020, 1035, 1035 divided by 3. I'm just going to cheat this time to make sure I write the right answer right, or the first time, is 345 degrees. And there are three good examples of how to find roots of complex numbers in polar form. I'm Mr. True. Bam! Go do your homework. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you're finding these to be helpful. Thank you again.